David and Louise Turpin leave West Virginia for Texas. Their fresh start hits younger sister Elizabeth hard.
We had a tape player recently with, and she left a message on it, and we kept the recording. And she was telling me how much she loved me before she left, because she knew she was going away.
Why Texas? It seems David has a job there. Elizabeth says they kept up with occasional visits back to West Virginia, and things seem okay.
They acted the same around me. David was good to me. She was good to me.
It's here in Texas where the Turpins begin having children. And slowly, Elizabeth says visits back home stop. Contact becomes ever more sporadic.
I started having more kids. They became more and more distant, and I got to where, by the time I had the fourth one, they quit coming in.
And it was during one of those last visits, Elizabeth says, that she asked her sister a question.
How about I go stay with you for the summer instead of mommy or daddy?
Elizabeth moves in with Louise, David, and their four young children in this house in Fort Worth, Texas. Soon after, she says, she starts noticing that things are a bit off.
I remember they were really strict on the oldest daughter. She was bounced her room a lot. They would let her come down and eat meals. She would have to get permission to sit down. She was in the early, maybe fifth or first grade. She had to look her mom in the eye, and there had to be a smile between them. She'd tell her, go ahead. And then she would eat, and it was just the same routine every day.
Elizabeth remembers more than just strict rules. She says the kids were kept in their rooms for long stretches of time. Her contact with her nieces and nephews was limited.
It was almost like she didn't want me talking to the kids, and they weren't allowed to talk to me without permission.
Although she feels uneasy about the situation, she also feels unable to speak up.
Maybe I should question her parenting. I mean, what did I have to offer? I'm 19, 20 years old, you know. I wasn't comfortable with her like I used to be.
Another startling discovery? She says she finds her sister and brother-in-law drifting away from their strict Pentecostal upbringing.
They didn't want to bring their kids up in church. They don't trust church people. I do know that she started getting into checking out other religions. They read up on, like, witch doctors and stuff like that. I remember her looking into Mormonism, Catholics, and Mennonites.
Elizabeth says the Turpins adopted a type of hybrid religion, one that she thinks sparks those strict house rules, rules that also apply to Elizabeth.
I was told I couldn't make phone calls, or wasn't allowed to have anybody over. I wasn't allowed to tell.